Now, this is actually my first time going turkey hunting. This is actually a first for both of us. But I've been hunting all my life, and she's kind of been around hunting a little bit for her whole life as well. And when we had the opportunity to come here to Cabin Bluff and try to bag a turkey, I was all over it. And with my partnership with NWTF and the kind of the things that we've been working towards, this was a part of what we had the opportunity to do. So it was an opportunity that we just couldn't pass up. Had to come out here and have some fun and try to get our first turkey. My partnership with National Wild Turkey Federation started just over a year ago before the Rio Olympics. And we partnered together to not only grow the awareness for the outdoors, but also for the shooting sports. What National Wild Turkey Federation has done is they've created the Palmetto Shooting Complex there in South Carolina. And it's basically an outdoor recreation center where people can go and just experience the outdoors. And they've got fishing ponds there. They've got an ample amount of land to just roam around, to go hiking on. They also have rifle, pistol, shotgun, 3D archery, all kinds of different things for people to just come out and experience, not just shooting, not just hunting, just the outdoors, and to have fun. And for me, I love being able to give back to the outdoors, love being able to give back to the shooting community and help grow it as a whole. When I was just turning 12 years old, I found out that I could go to the Olympics. And I told my parents after the second time I'd ever shot the discipline of Olympic skeet that I wanted to go to the Olympics and I wanted to win a gold medal. So I did everything that I possibly could and trained and just fought my way to the top and was able to win in both Beijing and London. And going on, my passion is for the shooting sports, but it's not just for winning medals. That's something that I've done, and yeah, it's been fun, but it's more about the legacy that you can leave behind. And in my partnership with NWTF, it's allowed me to give back to kids, and which is very, very close to my heart. I love working with kids, and that's close to their heart as well. So just knowing that together we can help grow the shooting sports and possibly make more outdoors people, and that's really what it's all about.
Never experienced a turkey hunt before, so this is definitely the first for me, and I was really thankful that he asked me to be the guest while he did the turkey hunt, and it was a lot of fun. We had a really great time today.
Yeah, we did. It was a lot of fun, and thankfully we came to one of our favorite places in the whole world, at Cabin Bluff. It's in the southeast part of Georgia, and they've got everything here, so being able to be a part of it on such a beautiful place with a great guide, we had a lot of fun. We got to see a lot of birds, and thankfully we had two that cooperated as well. Thankfully we were able to bag both of our birds pretty quick this morning. It started off a little slow. The first place we went to, we had one hen come in, but not really anything else. And as we were headed back out to go to a different spot, we actually jumped one on the side of the road. So our guide kind of pulled us off around a corner, and we hopped back over and set up a couple decoys, and he started hitting the call a few times, and here he came. Awesome that you get to come to our favorite place and
get my first turkey.
Get your first turkey.
Absolutely.
Now I gotta get one. And you know, we're very competitive with almost everything that we do, but
now you've gotta get one bigger than mine,
no.
Right?
You know, I don't know if I can. That's a good bird. It's a really pretty bird. And quite the first bird too, while you're at it. Well, I guess we'll head off and see if we can find one for me.
Let's go. So it worked out great, and it ended up being a really awesome experience.
Yeah, really good bird too. Really good bird.
Hi, I'm Vincent Hancock, Olympic skeet shooter, 3-time Olympian and 2-time Olympic gold medalist. I'm here at Palmetto Shooting Complex at NWTF, and one of the things I want to talk about is how to get a proper gun mount. Now, there's a lot of different ways that a lot of different people mount the gun, but what you're ultimately looking for is to have the gun solid in your shoulder and have your face have a proper cheek weld on the gun, so that way you can have proper sight alignment. So what it looks like is pretty much this. Nice and tight in your shoulder, head nice and tight down, and proper alignment. If you're interested in getting involved in the shooting sports, I would highly recommend finding an instructor. Make sure they're certified, either NSSA, NSCA, or NRA, and make sure they have insurance. Do your research and find someone that's going to be a right fit for you. I'm a huge advocate for youth shooting sports. Having grown up and shot 4-H and a Scholastic Clay Target program, it's near and dear to my heart to get new kids involved in the shooting sports. And if you're out there and you're in middle school or high school, there's opportunities for you to be involved with a shooting program. A lot of high schools are now getting programs started where you can actually be a lettering athlete in those sports. And check and see if your school has one. If they don't, start one. It's a great opportunity for you to go out, join a team, be a part of something that's bigger than just yourself, and have a lot of fun shooting clay targets. When I was a teenager, we put a lot of emphasis on chunk training, and that's picking one station out and shooting that over and over and over again. What that's doing is building muscle memory. A lot of people call it muscle memory. It's truly teaching your body and your nerves the right motions to make. It really doesn't have much to do with your muscles per se, but for the time being, we call it muscle memory. We stand on that station, we shoot it for hours and make sure that we can do the exact same move every single time. And this goes in hand in hand with being at home when you're not on the shooting range doing practice mounts. I've done tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of practice mounts at home before school and before I go to bed to make sure that my movements are very crisp. They're slow, smooth, and slow and smooth equal fast. In this game, the targets are traveling so fast, about 65 miles an hour, and we have to shoot singles and doubles all the way across the field. So you have to be on top of your game. Being quick is key, but the faster you try to get, the more jerky you get. So that's where these slow, smooth practice mounts come into play. Now we have kind of a routine that I do is 5 to 6 second practice mounts. And I'll just do a kind of a right to left, like I'm shooting a station 5 low house, so you guys can see. So I'm starting out here, obviously, in international skeet, we have a line here that our gun has to be down to. And what I'm gonna do is I'm visualizing the target coming out. So I'm combining visualization with the practice mount as well. So I'm setting up, getting my hold point, getting my eye hold point, and then as the target comes out, it's slow, and you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, bang. And you do that hundreds of times. Getting into the shooting sports can sometimes be confusing and complicated, but thankfully we have shooting ranges like the Palmetto Shooting Complex that you can come out to and get introduced to the shooting sports. A facility like this is a great opportunity to come out and have somebody show you around of what a skeet field is, what a trap range is, and what a sporting clays course looks like. And take advantage of those opportunities. Now, whether it be here at PSC or a local club that you're affiliated with or that you know of, go out to a range and ask somebody to show you around. Now, you don't have to have a shotgun, you don't have to have shells, you don't even really have to know what you're doing. It's the opportunity to go out and actually experience the shooting sports for yourself, which can grow into a love and a passion for the sport.
We want to hear from you. Share your hunting story. Be sure to hashtag it, MyNWTFStory. Share it so everybody can see it, and who knows, somebody here at NWTF might just send you something cool in the mail.
So after she got her bird, we packed everything up, and our guy Jody decided to take us on a couple different locations and see if we could find some more birds. And we went and checked a few places, mostly hens. There were a couple of jakes that we saw too, so we just kept on kind of moving around. And we finally got to a spot where we kind of peeked around the corner and we saw a couple hens, and we were just about to start walking back, and he's like, hey, hold on a second. Then out popped a bright red head. So we did a little more glassing on it and said, all right, this is a good bird. So we hopped back around, grabbed all of our gear from the truck, and went over and set up in a different location, kind of a funnel from the main field down towards the main trees and main brushy area where we knew they were probably gonna head to. So we set up there and got all cozy, cozy in the ground, and it took forever. The hens played around and he was following them, and probably an hour later, the hens finally walked off. We thought he had gone off the other end of the field, the opposite way, and then Jody walked over to the other side and glassed it a couple more times and hit a few more calls, and then here it came.
That's pretty cool right there.
Heck yeah, right? Birds weren't really talking to us today. It was really windy out, but to get the experience of watching him come in and strut, that was totally worth all the patience that it took to get that bird to come in. And obviously having a place like Cabin Bluff and having a guy like Jody, I'm so grateful to be here at a place like this. It's just a beautiful, beautiful resort. Cabin Bluff is our favorite place in the whole world to be, and outside of home, of course. And we couldn't have done it without National Wild Turkey Federation either. So thank you to the partnership that we have with NWTF and for the hospitality that Cabin Bluff has shown us.